Today we have an inspiring woman with us who's been at the forefront of empowering the next generation in the tech world. She's the former CEO of Black Girls Code and is now making waves with new ventures focused on innovation. Welcome to Live at 9, Kimberly Bryant.
Thank you so much for having me. It's an honor to be here.
Yes, okay, so let's explain your journey. So you started with Black Girls Code, and now you have current projects that involve venture capital and an innovation lab. Walk me through everything.
Yes. So back in 2011, I was living in the Bay Area, working in biotech, and my daughter was starting to become a middle schooler and get interested in technology. And there wasn't a lot of programs or really anything basically focused on girls of color. And so I created that with Black Girls Code, really driven by my love and like fierce protection of my daughter, wanting her to get into technology. And that program grew for 10 years. There's even a chapter here in Memphis. But as I transitioned in the last couple of years from leading that organization, I saw that there was even a greater need to have more women of color and people from marginalized communities really starting these tech companies, not just going to work at them. And that's my goal now. And coming home to Memphis is just a full circle moment to be able to do it.
Okay, let's talk about this. Black Innovation District. Mm-hmm. Explain to me what that is, what that's going to look like.
So very interesting. I was scrolling through Twitter as I tend to do a lot.
It's X now.
Well, X.
I'm just kidding.
It's X. It's still Twitter.
It's still Twitter. Tweet.
Yeah, and I stumbled across this beautiful story of Griggs College here in Memphis that this architect Stephanie Wade was bringing back to life and putting on the historic registry. And I really stalked her and tried to get an intro to her because I was like, I have an idea. And the idea is to create the Black Innovation Lab, which would be this hub and accelerator to really help women like those that I even train maybe in Black Girls Code to become entrepreneurs, but not just doing this right in the lab, but really creating that whole block as a district or a Black Wall Street right here in Memphis by reinvigorating the area and bringing all of the resources that I've gained over the last 10 plus years in Silicon Valley to create that type of acceleration around innovation here in Memphis.
Okay, VC, some of us, you know that like the back of your hand, but can you explain what you're doing with venture capital and what that would mean to this initiative?
Absolutely. So what we're doing is not only just bringing opportunities to these technology entrepreneurs, the biggest thing that they often need is capital. So one of the ways to get capital into these companies is called venture capital. And in the Bay Area, it's sort of the home or birthplace of venture capital, where we as general partners and LPs can actually create funds that infuse that capital into these startup companies when they needed the most to accelerate and build their vision, expand it. And that's what I hope to do as part of the Ascend Ventures arm of Black Innovation Lab is create a fund that really invests in these founders right here in the Mid-South and in the Southern region where there's maybe 1% of venture capital dollars going today.
Okay, why is Memphis a good fit? I think I can guess, but why was this the place that you wanted to come to with this?
Well, I think what we see within the venture capital industry is that most of the current accumulation of wealth is on the coast. It's either in the Bay Area or New York, a little bit up into Boston.
Austin, Texas,
maybe.
A little bit.
A fraction, though, of the dollars that are going into venture capital every year are going to the South. Yet, so many marginalized founders actually live in the U.S. South. So there's no dearth of talent, but there's a dearth of opportunity and capital for these entrepreneurs to grow. So that's why I thought it was important for me to bring all those skills and contacts I've learned elsewhere back to my hometown because our talent is rich and the opportunity is here.
Okay, how can people connect with the Innovation Lab and the VC?
Yes.
Funding.
They can look us up at blackinnovationlab.org. We are building out our space, hopefully in Griggs College this year, but reach out to us online and find ways to partner because we'll also be doing things virtually over the next 12 months.
Kimberly Bryant, you said the word dearth I have never said it or even heard of it. I'm going to be in the dictionary. I know I got an idea. I just want to thank you for stepping into a space that is new for our area and for opening people's minds. So thank you so much for your time.
Thank you so much for having me.
Kimberly Bryant. Straight ahead, a visit to Wolf Chase Galleria offers more than just a chance to shop this weekend. We'll explain how, plus